Hi guys, welcome to Core Java Interview Questions. So today we are going to discuss about JP Morgan online coding test. Okay, so let's start with our topic. So before starting with our questions, let's check what is the pattern of JP Morgan online coding test. Okay, so basically this time when I appeared for the test, they gave only two questions and that was of 90 minutes. Both the questions was related to data structure and core Java. Okay, so few of the concepts of data structure, and it was to be implemented in core Java. Okay, if you are an average coder, you can able to resolve these both questions in 30 minutes only, because I did it in, I think so, 18 or 17 minutes I completed both of the questions. So it was not hard questions, neither they check for the time complexity as well. So even though if you can do it in n square, it's fine. Only the questions should be solved. That's all. There is no constant like in a Hacker Earth or Hacker Rank. We saw there is time complexity also in a tests, right? To get tests to be executed. But here there is no such type of abstraction. Okay. So let's start with our coding questions. So the first question was find the smallest kth element in an unsorted array. If a smallest kth element is not found, return null. Okay, so this was the first question. Okay, so input was something like this: first line will be the kth element and the second line will be an array of integers. Okay, so input you can able to see like this, kth element will be like this, and output you have to generate. Okay, so the first line, what it consists of is the kth element. Okay, so what is the kth element? Smallest kth element, right? So here let's understand how what is this question. So kth element is 3. So first smallest element is 0, second smallest element is 1, but we don't have third smallest element here. Okay, so our output should be null, because it says like if smallest kth element is not present, return null. Okay, and second input we will see the first smallest element is 2, second smallest element is 3, third smallest element is 5, and fourth smallest element is 7. And we have to predict the fourth smallest element. So output is 7. So this was the question. And we were supposed to read the console. And from the console, we will have two lines. First, we'll tell the kth element. And second, we'll have the integer array, which we have to read it. And then we have to process the record. Okay. So let's look at the answer, how we can able to solve it. Okay, so here we can read the console value either can be buffered reader or through scanner. Okay, any one of them. Buffered reader is more time utilized, means it can give more optimistic result, buffer reader. So time complex, with the help of buffer reader, time complexity will be less, and a scanner will take little more time complexity. Okay, because reading through a scanner is little time consuming. Okay, but as we don't have any time constraint here, so we can use any one of them. Okay, and once you have the data ready, you can create a method like get kth element, and you can pass a list of string that integer values and the kth element, what is the number of that kth integer value. Okay, and what you can perform, you can do merge sorting in that, or find the unique element first, then do merge sorting and return the kth element. Okay, so it should be performed like that. Okay, so let's see how we can do with the help of coding. Okay, when we are in a coding. So what we are doing, first finding the unique element. So take a hash set and find the unique element of that. Merge sort, you can use collection.sort, and then you can return the kth element. So in this way, you can find the kth element of it. There are n ways to do it, but what I got and what I liked it on the basis of n log n complexity, because I always preferred any sorting with whenever sorting is required, I preferred merge sort because it gives n log n. So that's why it depends upon what is the time optimization you are looking for and how optimized you can able to solve. Okay, so this was my approach. There is more better approach than this as well, but it depends upon the solving time also, right? So whatever comes to your mind first, you try to approach that, and then you can able to rectify more and more or optimize more and more later to that. Okay, so let's look at the second question. What was the second question? So second question was quite straight easy. There were a string provided. Okay, so let's read out the question first, and I will explain you later. A string is provided as an input from console, which consists of integer value. Okay, so like this integer value will be provided. Okay, insert asterisk if subsequent numbers are even, and insert hyphen if subsequent numbers are odd. Okay, so let's look at the examples. When you have input like this, you have to check 2, 1 both are odd and even and odd. Okay, so that's fine. Again, 1 and 4 both are odd and even, that's fine. 4 and 6 both are even. Okay, so you have to insert asterisk mark between them. Again, 6, 2 both are even, insert asterisk. 2, 6 again asterisk. 6, 7 odd even, perfectly fine. But 7, 5 both are odd, so insert hyphen. 5, 7 insert hyphen, because both are even. In such a way, you have to generate the output. Okay, so again, for this question as well, we can do in two ways. Either you can traverse from first to end and perform an operation, okay, or you can do front wise and back wise simultaneously and perform the operation. Okay, so let's see how we can able to do that. Again, reading can be done by buffered reader or scanner, any one of them, which approach you find better, because there is no time complexity constraint here, as this is JP Morgan. It Chase itself provide their own ID to resolve these questions, and for that there will be 2 to 3 input of results for that. Okay, input test cases for that, and only that 3 to 4 test cases you need to resolve it, that's all. Okay, so let's understand. So if we iterate over the string and then we try to modify that it is string, so our time complexity becomes n. But if we iterate from front end and back side as well, our time complexity become n by 2. Okay, so here we can say we can not able to optimize up till log n, but we can able to reduce some time of time complexity. So both is fine here. Coding if we code, it's very straightforward. We can iterate over a for loop and we can do it. Here we have to iterate over n by 2 of a for loop, and then we have to go from 0 as well as n minus 1 of n minus 1 plus 0 as well. Okay, so in both the front end and back end side, both side we have to iterate and we have to resolve the problem. Okay, so this was the only two questions what I can say. It was given to me in a test, and which I straightforwardly completed the test. This online test is the third round basically. Once you cleared 2 to 3 rounds of technical interview, then they provide this coding test. Okay, for JP Morgan. I completed this JP Morgan test and I have cleared this JP Morgan interview for third time. So I thought why not to share my experience with you guys so that you can able to get some idea about JP Morgan, who is interested in JP Morgan. It's a good organization again, but due to some constraint, I couldn't able to join this organization. So it's okay. It's up on the individual what people like. So I think so, guys, you would have got some idea about how the question comes for JP Morgan interview. Okay. So if you guys like this video, kindly subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you will be getting further videos, right? Okay, thanks guys. Thanks for watching this video once again.